Asteroids, a space rock that could hit planet Earth and cause some serious damage. A volcano, a mountain with a passage to the Earth's crust, which can spew lava, ash, and gas, and cause serious damage. While we can see asteroids coming a little ways off, and we receive some warning signs about impending volcanic activity, little can be done to stop either, both of which are separate natural disasters waiting to happen. But what if they weren't so separate? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate, and today we are asking, what if an asteroid hit the Yellowstone volcano? Blimey, what drama! Before we get into this video, why don't you guys let me know if you have ever seen a shooting star or been up close to a volcano? I've been to Iceland, which is pretty volcanic. While you're down there in the comments section, why don't you leave a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to Life's Biggest Questions if you haven't already. Do make sure you stick around to the end of the video too, where I'm going to be reading some replies to some previous comments. Okay, before we dig deep into this question, let me talk to you a little bit about the Yellowstone volcano and asteroids likely to hit Earth separately before we marry them together. Scientists are constantly monitoring Yellowstone National Park for volcanic activity around the calderas. Why? Well, it's one of the biggest active volcanoes in the world and one of the most feared eruptions. Despite not erupting for 640,000 years, the eruption before that took place 1.3 million years ago, and the one before that 2.1 million years ago, which means we could be due a huge blow soon. Now this would be devastating. The last time the volcano blew, there weren't towns, cities, states, or even humanity to destroy. These days, the volcano erupting would obliterate everything within a 100 kilometer radius and spread ash as far away as 800 kilometers from the epicenter, which has the potential to kill millions and destroy the world's ecosystem for a decade or more. Okay, great. Great. Meanwhile, asteroids and life on Earth have a very checkered history. We all know that a huge asteroid triggered the events that killed off the dinosaurs. The Chicxulub asteroid was estimated to be between 11 and 81 kilometers wide, which is big. So big. That hit Mexico's Yucatan Peninsula with the energy of between 21 and 921 billion Hiroshima atomic bombs. Again, a very big swing, but a huge force. Interestingly, it seems that this asteroid sent ripples around the Earth's tectonic plates that then triggered massive volcanic eruptions from underwater volcanoes. This likely sent all kinds of volcanic matter into the air, along with the dust from the asteroid impact, which worked together to choke the dinosaurs and other wildlife and block out the sun. This was, make no mistake, a big boy asteroid, and it didn't hit a volcano, but still, it managed to trigger some. If an asteroid hit the Yellowstone volcano, the amount of damage would very much depend on how big the asteroid is. Leaving asteroids out of it for a second, I can already answer the question for you of what would happen if we nuked Yellowstone, and the answer is not a lot. The most explosive weapon in the world that we have right now is the Tsar bomber. This is 50 megatrons, and that is comparable to a large earthquake. We actually had a very similar amount of energy in an earthquake that happened in the region in the 1970s that measured 7.3 in the Richter scale, and basically all that happened was a few popping hot springs and geyser activity. Man can't make explosions as big as nature can, and even then, asteroids anywhere near big enough to mess with Yellowstone are extremely few and far between. Need I remind you that the Chicxulub asteroid arrived 66 million years ago, and since then, there hasn't been a notable impact event of an object 10 kilometers wide or more. In the past few hundred years, our biggest threats have been meteors, which are too small to be considered asteroids. The last few asteroids that we had that hit the Earth, including the 2018 LA event that impacted in South Africa, have been no more than 5 meters wide, and that is, I mean, extremely paltry to say the least in terms of asteroid size. It would need to be an asteroid the likes of which we haven't seen in millions of years to even make any damage surrounding Yellowstone, and yes, if it did hit Yellowstone, then it would likely affect the volcano, likely causing a lava eruption, and it would be a nightmare. But like, actually, probably better that the massive meteor slash asteroid hit the volcano and keep the impact zone at a singular zone of total and utter possible life-ending chaos, rather than hit a few hundred kilometers away and trigger an eruption creating two death zones. To be honest, if an asteroid of dinosaur-killing proportions did hit the Earth, it kind of becomes somewhat irrelevant where it hits. But if it did trigger the Yellowstone, then we would go from screwed to affirmatively screwed. Death, death, extinction, death. But again, don't you worry guys, an asteroid of that size isn't so much as on our radar, let alone on course to impact the Earth, so worry not. At this point, it's basically the stuff of fantasy. So guys, that was that. Don't forget to let me know if you've ever seen a shooting star or if you've ever been to a volcano up close. Or perhaps you live near one. Does anyone live near Yellowstone? I would love to hear from you. Okay, before I go, I'm just going to read some comments from one of my most recent Life's Biggest Questions videos. I'm going to be replying to What If Cupid Was Real? Beast's Rap Instrumental said, I just love these kind of videos. Good! I'm glad you love them. Please keep on watching. SpongeBob SquarePants said, Roses are red, violets are blue, I am single and so are you. How did you know? Minecraft Silent Build said, Cupid has to be real or what's with love or love at first sight? I would say maybe it's lust caused by hormones and pheromones, my friends, so. So, there we go. Please do like this video and share it with a friend, and if you have not yet subscribed to Life's Biggest Questions, do it! I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate. I'll catch you in the next video, but until then, stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning.